This is a middle-range principle, this is a long-range principle. All right, let's assume that I'm over here follows. Okay, so my knife for right now, for this train right now, will be out like this. Okay, so that means I can thrust it palm up, I can thrust it palm down, right? I can even thrust up here, or I can slash here, I can slash here. Let's assume the first thrust is like that, just like that, or back like that. Some people put it like that, many different ways. So the first one is evade and slap. That means she uses distance, okay? I slash here, okay, she slashes here. That's it, okay, a little bit farther away. Bang, all right. Now, when I'm in middle range, sometimes you support it with a hand parry, okay? When you're in close, if I thrust particularly, all right, now close, this is cover and slash. Okay, so what I want you to do is attack with this one here. That's cover and slash. All right, this is parry and slash, okay? And this is evade and slash. Okay, so what I want you to do is either palm up, okay, or palm down thrust, or slash, and apply the principle. All right, what's the first principle? The first principle is evade, slash. Second principle, parry and slash. Third principle, cover and slash. The principle will work even if it's low. So if I'm low and she uses evasion, right? She's in middle range right now, that's parry and slash. But evade and slash is longer, right? If she evades and slash, she's moving into middle range right now, okay? Right then, cover and slash is when you actually put the hand like that and it covers the slash together like this. Okay, so you know, because it should be very natural. When you go into, you realize by the range of the distance, okay? All right, at the low line, the principle will still be evade, and slash. The other one will be parry, and slash, cover and slash, when you smother it. Whether it's at this line, or whether it's this line, the principle will still work. Okay, that line here, that's the distance. You should clear it. You should clear it to make sure. Okay, when you clear it, on the evade slash, you can stay out at long range. She did try once. She's staying at that range. But now she comes in, see, she's coming in the middle range. All right, any questions? All right, so what I want you to do is just attack. Just attack here, see. Slash, see, thrust. Single direct attack. Not double. Double is when like this and you fade. Okay, so that's single direct attack, see. Single direct attack, single direct attack, single direct attack, single direct attack. Single direct attack. Okay? This is a single direct attack. Anything I stick out there, she will slash it, like that, slash it. So usually, if you train the high and low, if I go high like that, so I'm gonna go low like that, see? Or I go low like that, go high like that. You're gonna pick it up. Okay? All right, so 1 minute, I want you, all you to do is feed this guy single direct attack. Don't fake it, don't go high and low like this here. Okay, let's try it over there, okay? All right, one side feeding it for 1 minute. Okay? Go through like this, or I can fake this way and go like that. So we take the first one, high to high, okay? Low to high. Center thrust to high thrust. Okay, any questions again? Look at it. High thrust, okay? Middle thrust, high thrust. Center thrust, a high thrust, okay? This one here, they usually don't attack as an opening. But if they do this, it's just to go up here like that. Okay, so this is from high to high. Okay, middle to high. Center thrust, okay, so now I want you to receive and apply one of the three principles, okay? From one to three. That means you can evade the first one, and then come in. See, that she's evading, right? Then she is parrying, and then come in. She's coming in, okay? All right, over here, evade or parry. Okay, you apply any from one to three of the principles, because I don't know what range you're gonna be in. That you have to look to see. Okay, long range means this, okay? That you're out of range of that, just hold it like that. You're out of range of that completely, and you're just going like that, pat, right? Middle range is that your left hand can touch that. See, close quarter is because you're in here inside the arm. You can't get out. Whether it's like this, okay, or whether it's like this, see, it doesn't matter. Okay, all right, so what I want you to apply. Now, what I want you to do is apply, because we're gonna learn to go from middle range to close quarter. So we learn it both, you can stay out of range and you can do the same thing. All right, so when you go like this, when you go like this and you come in, I want you just to come down to the low line. That's all I want. See how she scrapes? And the dagger comes in here. Many people had this before, okay? Then I go from this line to that line, see? She come in, eye poke, eject, both daggers in, okay? You can strip and lock and then do whatever you want to do from there, all right? Then you have the center thrust, which you deliver here like that. Okay, come in, stab, and thrust, strip, okay, elbow, and knee, and so on, okay? The attack can be positive. That means I can try to hit here, and try to go here, or I can fake here, go here. Doesn't matter. So we call it negative positive. Negative positive is if we fake it here and go here, okay? And we come back to low line and we turn, okay? Then over here is a negative, positive, okay? And we're attacking what they call thrust to thrust. Okay, any questions? So we're gonna return the blade to the low line, okay? Any questions over there? We're gonna try that just for about a 3 minute round, okay? Let's try it, okay? Same three principles, okay? All right? But we will go into the high return. Okay, the low return, if I stay here and went over here, that is the low return, okay? The high return, okay, if I come here, notice where the stab is in the bicep, this hits the elbow joint, the thumb is in the eye, the knee is in the thigh, okay, this could be flat for the stick, or it could be the edge of the stick here, the elbow can hit, the knee can hit, knee's here, and if you want to take down, you can take down, okay? Okay, now, what I was talking about, any at all, if you have a throwing object, throw it. Always throw it. Okay, we'll move back again to that point because I don't know if I see like that's your dummy wallet. See, because when it's in the view of the thing, that's when you can come in and attack. Okay. The dummy key, okay, anything. Because that little timing will help your timing. Because if you go like that, then you just look for the hand, see? And you go to the hand. Like that will help you in your entry.